Myself, Supriya Pasnur, working as an assistant professor in civil department from Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today's class, we are going to discuss the principles of the building planning. So at the end of this session, students will be able to impart the knowledge and apply the principles of the planning and design of the residential building. These are the principles of planning. As in the previous lecture, we have seen the first six principles. So following will be the principles which will be discussed. That is the furniture requirement. That is the seventh principle. Here you can pause the video for 2 minutes and try to give the answer for this. What do you mean by the pedestrian planning? This is the answer for that. First, we have to consider the best pedestrian plan, which is be good for the land use. So make sure the buildings relate to the side walls rather than the parking lots. Make sure buildings are pleasure to walk. The streets should have a leafy environment, and the traffic should be calm. They promote safe routes to the schools. And even the design streets with the pedestrian in mind, so that they should have a cheerful environment. Provide attractive, consistent lighting of the pedestrian rim. These are the points which should be considered in the pedestrian planning. Next is the furniture requirement. So this is one of the most important principle which should be considered in the planning. So actually the furniture requirement, the room should be done, room size is based on the furniture size. So what type of furniture or what is the size of the furniture to be made in the room? So during building planning, the size of the furniture to be required for that particular function of the room should be considered. Actually the kitchen where we see it has a platform, a cupboards will be provided, the dining table and refrigerator, etc. And even in the bedroom, we have the bed, the side tables and the dressing tables, etc. should be considered. So actually the room dimensions will be done on the basis of the dimensions and the size of the room or some of the permanent furniture, if existing, that will be considered during the size of the room. Next is the economy. This is one of the important principles which should be considered. Actually, economy includes all the principles which should be considered in planning of the building. Actually, this should be carried out in the financial limit of the client. That will be based on the client's budget, which should be in the limited amount. A building should have the minimum floor area of the maximum utility, and also all the principles are to be considered during the planning. Economy means not to compromise in designing and achieving the strength of a particular material like concrete. Economy means the proper utilization of the space by its maximum utility. Economy can be achieved by the reducing the story height. It can be achieved by reducing the steps of the staircase, by standardizing the materials which can be used. Next is the elegance. It refers to the planning of the elevation and layout of the plan to give an impressive appearance to the building. This depends upon the elevation of the building, which is seen from the outside. Even the proper width, the height, the location of the doors and the windows, materials employed in the construction of external wall, etc., create the elegance. The result of the elegance is aesthetics of the building. The better elegance, can be obtained by the proper positioning of the doors and the windows, the superior building materials should be used for the better elegance, like the polished stones, marbles, etc. Use of the arches in the entrance itself can be used. Even designer doors and the windows have to be used for the elegant purpose. Next is the sanitation. Sanitation has to be improved by the provision of the cleanliness, the lighting and the ventilation in the sanitary units, which will avoid the growth of the bacteria and spread of the disease and give the hygienic condition. Bathtubs, the unitary, WC pans, wash basins, the kitchen sinks should be of ceramic materials to maintain them clean easily. It can be achieved by the following factors: natural light and the ventilation. To enjoy the natural sunlight, the window size should be of the sufficiently big. Actually, the window for the hot area, the window for the hot unit climate, it should be 1/7 to 1/8 of the floor area, and a minimum window size during the wet dry climate should be 1/10 of the floor area. This is used for the sanitation purpose. Next is the circulation. It is an important factor. All the passages should be straight, short, sufficiently lighted and ventilated to achieve a maximum convenience and the comfort. The passages should not disturb the privacy of the rooms when being used. There are both types of the circulations, as we have the horizontal circulation and the vertical circulation. Horizontal circulation includes the passages which are leading to the other rooms, and the vertical circulation includes the staircases, the ramps, escalators, etc. These are the references which I have referred. Thank you.